Yo, yo, FTD fam, what's happening, guys? So Ali Dawa is on the front lines confronting pro-Israeli people. Let's see what he says. It's just a bad language. Your discretion is advised. Okay, guys, so disclaimer. Nobody social distancing.
Crusader supporter. Crusader supporter. Crusader supporter.
He's coming to me by Hamas. You punk.
You coward.
Look at this. Look at this. This is Israel. This is Israel. You coward. You dare come to me about Hamas. Hamas. You're blowing babies. Israel are blowing babies. Look at this.
And they go coward. Christian coward.
Look
at
this.
Okay, he condemns it. Okay, I can't barely hear anything.
Ali, 40, 41, today.
Christian,
Hey, this is not a conversation, it's just a yelling match right now.
Anybody that says,
shame on your biblical God.
Anybody that comes and says to me, Israel conflict, Oxenbillah, you know what they're saying? They have no problem with Muslim brothers. Anyone that comes to me and says, Israeli conflict, Israeli clash, you know what they're saying? We're having Muslim blood. How could you take Israel's side? You have to be a human being. How could you take Israel's side? From famous people to football teams, to the entire world. In Italy, a ship was coming with cargo, Israeli weapons, yeah? They said, we're not putting the cargo. This is humans. But these scumbags, bro, I don't care, I'm harsh, but I have no regrets. If it was my child, I've got a four-year-old daughter. Imagine my child getting blown into pieces. Are you stupid? And I'm gonna come here, Hamas. You think I'm gonna come here by Hamas? Look, if Hamas is targeting innocent people, I condemn them as well. It's not anyone. Even if it's Israeli kids. Yaaki, you're coming and talking about...
Sure, I agree with that. Even if it's Israeli kids.
Black belt, and I'm fighting a 10-year-old. Oh, he punched me.
Those kids are kids.
And I start cutting him into pieces. Are you going to come and say to me, yeah, but that kid hit him first. What are you talking about? You scumbag. These dirtbags. Uqsum billah, wallahi, they are happy when Muslim blood is spilled. Uqsum billah, I tell you, they don't care. And he's coming here. Can you imagine? He's coming with Hamas. I can sorry to scream in your ear. This, look, excuse me, this bastard. Look, I'm saying bastard. Yeah, I don't care what anyone cares. Ali Dawa, Islam, shut up. Shut your mouth. We know what Abu Bakr said to one, the Quraysh, yeah? What did he say? You know what he said to one of the this pagan Arabs, yeah? He said, go on. You know what it is, yeah? So let's not act like, you know, hunky dory Islam is peace. He's from flowers. Shut up, please. When there's a time, these bastard scumbags are coming here and question us about Hamas. Man, if Hamas is targeting innocent people, we condemn them. But the point is this, how are you talking about Hamas when Israel is blowing, they just blew up the Al Jazeera, you know, the BBC center, I mean, the media center.
Like, I get his point.
They left the building, boom. Okay, that's a media center, but at least they told people to leave the building. Rob, you're dropping bombs. You're blowing kids into pieces. There's pictures I can't show you. Yeah, you want to see this video, bro? Watch this video. Wallahi, you will cry. Look at this. Look at this. Wallahi, look at this. Look. Look
come on, coward,
that's
come on.
Dead. Look, look, look. This is a dead child. That's the father. Yeah? He's hugging his dead child.
Can't even really see him. I'm glad I can't see that, actually.
Imagine that was your child. Imagine that was your child.
Is that Israel or Hamas, Ali?
You're gonna come to Hamas. Look, look, look. Look, four of his kids. Four of his kids died, toddlers. And his wife died. And this scumbag's coming to me about Hamas. Look, look. Look. Look, look. You made Hamas. You created Hamas. Just as you created ISIS in Iraq, you created Hamas.
That's what happened.
Yeah, so most of that video, it was a shouting match back and forth. And I could, of course, you know, dig into it and see what Ali Dawa was saying. It's like, hey, why are you bringing up Hamas and all of that when you're not even saying what Israel is doing? You know, look what they're actually doing. And he also made it clear that his stance and the Muslim stance on a whole is if Hamas is targeting innocent people, kids and all of that, they're completely condemned because a child is a child. Innocent life is an innocent child. It doesn't matter what your nationality is, skin color, religion, you know, innocent is innocent. Child is child, period. That needs to be made clear. But I think why he was getting so upset was just because there was just no responsibility taken or nothing mentioned about the actions of the Israeli government and what they're doing and all of that, you know, going after the media station. It's just, you know, people are bringing up Hamas, like they're the bad guys and just kind of turning a blind eye to the Israeli government. So I get the frustration, I can see, and you know, this whole conversation, I don't think there's a current civil way to have this conversation yet, because I think it's too fresh, it's too emotional, it's happening right now. Like, these are lives being lost, lives being affected. This is big, and I haven't quite taken a look at the issue and saying like, is there a civil way yet? I just think we're at the point now where more noise needs to be made on the side of the Palestinians. And, you know, the powers that be need to be held in check, you know, the Israeli powers. And again, if Hamas is seen, you know, targeting innocent people, of course, that needs to be condemned. That needs to be kept in check as well. So at first I'm like, man, this is a shouting match. You know, how can we have a civil, normal conversation about this from both sides? And throughout the video, I was just like, okay, maybe there is none right now, you know, or at least I haven't figured out what that civil conversation would look like, what it would sound like. And I just feel now that this is time. Yeah, keep on making noise, keep on letting your voices be heard. You know, we see that there's a shift happening, right? There is a big shift. So yeah, that's where I'm gonna end this episode. I'll link to the original one below in the video description section. Also, I'll link to other related videos similar to this below as well. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Later.